Okay. So, we've returned. We ended last session with the rival battle and losing probably a great capture, but he wasn't doing so great so far. I think it was our second loss, right? Yeah, so far we've lost Sky, who had unfortunate timing on when we got Pokeball, and Farmer. Rest in peace. As of this moment, I don't exactly have a great replacement for Farmer. Possibly Agent here. But I think we're going to go hit up a few encounters that we've passed by so far. Before we head into the next gym. First, we'll get the encounter here in the forest. What have we got? That's not bad. That's not bad at all. Defensive, water, rock. Not terrible. Synergy's okay with our current party. Ice and rock both share some weaknesses, but... let's see if we capture it before we start thinking of any serious plans here. I don't recall if ice actually does half damage to water. I know rock will resist flying, but Coco is better with physical attacks, so that might not be a good idea. Unfortunately, we don't have any status moves. I think our best bet is the twins with their weak physical attack. Oh yeah, especially if he's going to be raising his defense. Oh yeah, we're going to tackle everyone over here. Revived from an ancient fossil, this Pokemon uses air stored in its shell to sink and rise in water, and apparently lives in the middle of the forest. The name for this is pretty obvious, right? So now we're going to go back and get, I think, 3 more encounters. It's going to be a bit of a walk, but considering the state of our party, I think it'll be worth it. Oh, we'll collect more apricots on the way back, too. Well, wait a second, let me think here. So the encounters that we've missed are, we can get the fishing rod here on Route 32, and then we can get encounters for fishing inside Violet City, Cherry Grove, and New Bark. We could just go forward, I guess, to the next gym, get an encounter on Route 34, Route 35, National Park, Route 36, then get the gym badge, then continue on through and get those 3 other encounters. I suppose rather than all this walking back and forth, that might be the better way to go. We might have to stop and do some grinding before we get to the gym, though. Especially for this run, I'm going to try to do better about leveling up the party to at least the level of the gym leader's highest Pokemon before we fight him. I've had a couple of rough runs because of the level jump between the 3rd and 4th gyms. First, we gotta help this guy catch his ducks. Let's see, do we want to move that experience share? Oh, he's got an item. An X special. Yeah, that's nothing. We'll get the twins up to 15 before we move it over. Although, I don't think there's any trainers in this forest, is there? one second, I'm gonna start another ready here that I'm listening to. I haven't really thought about HMs yet, have I? Good at HM Pokemon, do we? Let's see if Togepi can learn Cut. Probably not. Actually, let's try Starmie as well. It's Joey! How are you? Oh yeah, I saw a wild Magnemite. I thought about going for it, but then I failed. Oh well, I guess that's just the way it goes. I'm not very good at catching Pokemon. He's so modest. Alright. Nope, and nope. See if I mean, it seems like a shame to use Trapinch for HMs, but well, we do have a backup dragon if we need it later on, so. Frank can learn Rock Smash, but not Cut. Kind of tempted to go back and get those encounters now, because we don't have a good HM Pokemon. But I guess we just need Cut, don't we? Wait, did none of these three know how to use Cut, though? Guess Agent can learn both of them, huh? Oh, let's grab the egg. Oh, there's an item. Gotta go back and get it because it could be a master ball. If the foe sword taking some damage in the same turn, this attack's power is doubled. How would that even work? Like a double battle? for recoil damage. It's a dark attack. Extra coverage. Oh, that's our encounter. I think it probably has 40 hit points at level 10. It's fully evolved. Or not. Okay, never mind. That's fine. I wasn't really excited by the Pidgeotto. Or Pidgeot. Protected against critical hits, that's pretty cool. Whoa. 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 Okay. We're probably not going to be able to catch this with... Oh, sunlight. We're probably not going to be able to catch this with Pokeballs, but we will try. First, we definitely need to look up what moves it knows at level 10. Level 10, it should know Mudshot and a Scary Face. Supposedly. It's interesting. Okay. Level 10. There's a way to calculate what kind of hit points it has, likely. Pokemon Heart Gold HP calculator. It has between 40 and 43 hit points, likely. Okay, so this is not. We can't do this. Mudshot, scary face. Gives full immunity up to all ground type moves. So I think the twins will be immune to Groudon's attacks and can just slowly tackle him down. Okay. Yeah, I think we're just totally fine here to take this very slow. Question is, do we risk the crit? I think in order to have maximize our odds of catching this thing, we have to risk the crit. Uh-huh. Okay. I wish we had a status effect. Might as well burn the more powerful ones. I think we have the money to buy more Pokeballs, and we just bought some more trainers, so we should have plenty of cash. Save the better one. Nah, let's go ahead and try these. They're our best odds. Let's see if we burn through all of our options here. Oh no, it struggled! Oh man. Totally forgot about that. Dang it. Dang it. Oh, we're gonna buy more Pokeballs now. Did we just get a second TM12? Its natural enemy attacks, it oozes purple fluid and escapes. That's not bad. It's pretty good, actually. Thank you. extra sensory. What? User attacks with an odd and unseeable power may also make the foe flinch. Why does it know that? That's so weird. Ooh, it's gonna increase to special attack. Decrease special defense, though. Mm. This might be a pretty good Pokemon. Bulky guys are good for Nuzlockes, and Venusaur is pretty bulky. Oh, we do have an encounter here, though. Oh, there's another starter. And a really good one, too. Oh my goodness. Good. There we go. Just had to ask nicely. It lives a solitary life. Its wings deliver wicked blows that can snap even the thickest of trees. The penguin Pokemon. Why would the penguin Pokemon live where there are trees? Okay, so that's the end of this route, right? Yep. Gotta head back to the gym. Tackle, growl, bubble, wall, sport. I think it's worth it to swap out Lord Helix. Just because once. Alright, we hold off until we get to a higher level. We'll stick with the part we have right now. Probably should have thought us through a little bit more. Oh, that's a bummer. I wanted to use roll up. That's gonna lock us into being attacking. That's pretty good. Come on. There we go. Man, this experience shirt deck was so good. Fighting type. Gotta start another video. 1 second. Let's see. Let's see. Sleep powder's probably more useful than poison powder, honestly. But Vine Whip's not very good, so we'll go ahead and do that. Let's keep our powerhouse up front, I think. Pretty sure that's not a very good move. Power 15, accuracy 70. Yeah. Do we think we can survive this hit? Hit him with this and it's over. There we go. Okay. We can get some Ultra Balls now, I think. Misread something on the card. Do have stuff to sell though. Dang. What is the tree? Oh, something legendary. Oh my goodness. Okay, so we gotta do this again. See, what are the moves? What's this likely hit points? A lot of ace. Okay, so it has to have at least 40 hit points, which is good to know. At level 20, it knows Dragon Breath. Oh gosh. So we can't actually keep jams in here, because it'll get one hit KO'd, I think. And it knows Wish, likely, which is going to be a pain, because it'll heal itself over and over. Helping Hand, Save Card, Dragon Breath, Wish. So it's really just the Dragon Breath and the Wish that we're concerned about. Mm-hmm. a weird way to start. Oh, that's why I wanted to go to the twins for Snow Screen. What does Safeguard do, though? Does that prevent stats or status effects? Protected from status conditions. Okay, so we can still swap over and do 6 rounds of Smoke Screen. That's super effective. Yeah, we're gonna keep doing this. There's the wish. Oh my goodness. This might not be worth capturing. I don't know if that was worth it. I mean, it's a legendary. It's probably worth it, isn't it? It communicates using telepathy. Its body is covered in down that refracts light to make it invisible. Let's pull up with the moveset one more time. It's got Dragon Breath, though. That's going to carry it and be very good on the team for a long time. It's not going to learn much else of use until like level 35. Special attacks higher than physical attacks, so Dragon Claw is not going to do much on it. We can learn Surf though, that's good. Okay. My man Joey. Oh, you. I saw a wild merrill. I thought about going for it, but then I failed. Oh well, I guess that's just the way it goes. I'm not very good at catching Pokemon. Good old Joey. Okay. Let's go, bury our dead. And then get some encounters. Quinn's and Lord Helix. Rest in peace. Okay, so let's go get our encounters. I'm probably going to strut the video today, and I'll do some grinding to get the party up to around level 25 or so. TM65. Which one is that? Shadow Claw, that's not bad. Pretty good, actually. So we're gonna get our fishing rod and then we'll head up these towns. Oh, no, we can fish right here. is extremely ill-tempered. Groups of them will attack any handy target for no reason. It's pretty terrible. It absorbs electricity from telephone poles, shorts out its body to create crackling noises. Why? Another legendary. Oh my goodness. Okay. It has between 41 and 44 hit points, so that's perfect for dragon rage. Unless he has I don't think there is a nature that reduces hit points, is there? No, hit points are the one thing that's not affected. Now, let's see about his moves. Is he going to have something that's going to one hit KO jammed? Twister, Scary Face, Ancient Power. It does have a dragon attack with Twister, but it's only 40 power, and it's level 10. I think it'll be okay. There we go. There's the twister. Okay, that's not too bad. One. Two. There's a second twister, so we're gonna heal. Number one, you can do this. Perfect, perfect, perfect. This is maximum odds of capture. Oh, we got a legendary. Well, a second legendary. Oh my gosh. This was a good session. That does give us a second dragon, though. Third, if you count jams. It flies in the ozone layer, way up high in the sky. Until recently, no one had ever seen it. Until recently, it was found in a pond near a small village where the game starts. Okay. Oh, hey, we have somebody in the chat. I'm doing okay. We're doing a randomized Nuzlocke today, and we just caught two legendaries back to back. How are you doing, controller? Yeah, I just recently started watching some small ant stuff, and he turned me on to these. No problem. So, with the Sudowoodo encounter, I don't know, like 20 minutes ago, I just caught a Latias. And then, going back to the beginner town and fishing in the water to get the in-the-town encounter, we just caught a Rayquaza with a Cherry Berry. It's actually a tough pick to pick to pick what to go with here. We got too many dragons now. Oh, that's nice. That's real good. The professor just offering you God at the beginning. I think this is like my 7th or 8th attempt over the last few weeks. I got a Lugia once as the starter. This time we had... What was it? What was our starter? I really can't recall. Yeah, it's a tough call. I love Gastrodon. The typing is good and it's defensive. I would like for our Prinplup to live long enough to get the steel typing when it evolves. That would also be good defensively. But I don't know. It's going to be rough keeping it alive until that level, so Gastrodon might be the safer choice. Oh, actually, I think our starter was Jams here. We got one for the starter, and then we found one in the wilderness. True, true. Does this one have that? He does. Yeah, what does that do? Absorb water attacks, right? Draws in all water type moves. It's true. So it'd be great for swapping into waters. Yeah, I think it probably makes sense to go with him over Prinplup for now. If I get to a higher level where I can power level this guy up to his evolution, it might be better to use this one at that time. Okay, we'll do it. I will say probably the best find in this run is I've activated random items for captures, which is why this Rayquaza had a Cherry Berry. I think it was our Weezing that we caught, like, third or fourth capture, had an experience share on him. That has made this so much easier for getting Pokemon leveled up. So Rayquaza is a tough choice just because it'd be so slow to level. Indeed. I don't actually recall where you get the normal experience share in this game, but I've yet to see it. Okay. So let's see. We're going to the fourth gym next. I just circled around through the third gym, hit the Sudowoodo encounter, which was not a Sudowoodo, of course, and then hit the fishing encounters back in these towns. So we're headed to Ecruteak next. Yeah. Someplace in Goldenrod in the normal game. Probably somewhere around like when you go back to fight the Team Rocket or something, right? I don't know. We're set for now, though. I was thinking about it. If I could get something that has a thief attack, I could actually get more experience shares, I think. I'm not 100% certain how the randomized items work with this mod. If it's a random item for every Pokemon you capture, or if it's the species that then has a single item sometimes when you capture it. I don't know. I'm not really testing it when I'm doing a Nuzlocke. would be cool if it's the same item. If I could find something else that has useful items, I'd just steal that over and over. At least to sell. Before we head on to our next route, how are we doing with Pokeballs? I think we're okay. Yeah, we're okay. I'm sure I'm broke too. Yeah, we just spent everything we had on Pokeballs. Which was worth it to get that Rayquaza, I think. I would not have had those Ultra Balls otherwise. I gotta say, I've always really loved the city planning or geography between these three cities. How it, these three major population centers are all connected by this little squeezing path between these trees. Oh, and I do have randomized items on the ground. They're not randomized, technically they're shuffled. Any item that can be found on the ground somewhere can be found somewhere else. Like a paralyzed heal. Yeah, I played the games pretty religiously up until Black 2 and White 2, and I think Heart Gold and Soul Silver were probably some of my favorites as well. It was just big nostalgia, and the time where you could actually have your Pokemon follow behind you and emote at you. Good times. And plus, it's just the biggest game with 16 gyms. I guess we do want to fight this. Who's got the XP share? Number one. We'll swap that over. What does Betty actually know? Pretty solid with Dragon Breath. I will say, unlike the Rayquaza, Betty was actually pretty tough to capture. I think we lost both an Omanyte and the Weezing that I was running for a while, the one that we got the XP share from. Took them both down. Okay, so we're good to go. There's another trainer around here. Yeah. Ooh, it's actually on brand for this area. Let's see. Oh, this starts off with a water pulse. That's pretty good. 65, 85, you look on a RP water attack. I mean, anything's better than Mudsport. I honestly don't know why I'm collecting these. I guess it's also a nostalgia thing, because I remember collecting the different special Pokeballs when I was younger. Just because they look different. Is this our encounter? I didn't even think about that. This is our encounter. For this route. Because I got the Sudowoodo and then went immediately east. It didn't come this way. This isn't bad, I guess. Need a weak attack. Yeah, I think we have tackle here, don't we? This will work. Hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo! this guy before using him. Yeah, not worth it going for the sleep. Easy peasy. The extension and contraction of its muscles generates electricity. Its fur glows when it's in trouble. What's a good name for this guy? He glows. Let's call him Beacon. These ladies just hanging out in the wilderness. I see an ice type. Oh, it's both nice. I actually don't have anything good to swap to here. So I have to count on Betty being fast and strong to take this out. Okay, well, that's something. This might finish it. Nope. Okay, here we go. Oh, that's nothing. Well, that's something. Do I even have an item to fix that? Nope, I have a single full heal that I found in the ground somewhere. Well, again, I don't have anything better to swap into. It seems like my team has a serious ice weakness now. Until purple gets leveled up. Yeah, we'll use it. Frozen, and then use Dragon Breath to finish this guy off. Okay, also good for ice. Goodbye. Ooh, okay. We'll finish the cherim there. Shoot a wish here. Okay, good thing you didn't use that on Betty. That was a dark type attack, I believe. Oh, and that made him flinch because he didn't finish the cherim off. Oh, gosh. Why does it have two dark attacks? Okay. That's enough of that. James will do okay here now, especially now that we got 2-1. Nope, that's the wrong swap. And that's also the wrong swap. Oh my goodness. Stupid, stupid, stupid. Okay. Easy peasy. Definitely didn't lose, almost lose a couple Pokemon. Put up somebody fast back out up front. There we go. Okay. There's our man Bill, who now gives us an encounter back in Goldenrod. Oh man. I hate to say it, but it's time to grind. This guy evolved too, to give him a stat boost. One more level, I think. Well, that's not cool. Sixteen apparently. I'll say this was a pretty cool encounter, our Bulbasaur. It was actually the mystery egg that we got from the professor after the first gym, I think? Yeah, after the first gym. Last few times I've run this, the egg is always something supremely disappointing. How are his stats comparing now? 20s to 30s, 50 HP, way higher, but that's a legendary. 30s to 40s, 20 to 30 with 50 attack, 20s all around, but also underleveled. And that's our HM, boy. I guess we're gonna do these trainers over to the west side to get some more levels. Or at least the wild encounters to get better XP. Oh. We'll get this guy first, then grab that. Good. We'll be using Ivysaur or Venusaur. I should probably check the accuracy of these moves. That's 75, that's 90, that's pretty accurate. So always start with the Leech Seed, I guess. Man, this ice weakness sucks. And water. Oh, that's the rival. Or not the rival, the sidekick character. I totally thought his name was Brendan. Waterstone. We do actually have a star you, so that could be useful. Not a great encounter. Luminian swimming in darkness of the deep sea looks like stars shining in the night sky. What do we think? Probably never gonna use this. It could be an HM boy though. Let's go grab strength. Ooh. Sleep talk, yeah. I think it's only good for rest combinations, and you don't want to use that Nuzlocke. Ooh. Okay. Getting pretty lucky with these legendaries now. We're gonna take a few seconds to be boring and look up what moves does it know. And then I think we wanna look up what its average hit points are at this level so we know if we can just drag and rage it. Heart Gold Zapdos moves. Level 13. Knows Thunder Wave, Thunder Shock, and Peck. It is a flying move, so that's not good for our boy Ivysaur. And then for his hit points. Crunch numbers. Oh man, it has 38 to 41 hit points, so we cannot Dragon Rage it. Okay. I think regardless, though, we want to pull Jams out to Sand Attack it. Yeah. It's got Thunder Shock, Thunder Wave, and Peck, so we can only use Peck on Jams. So he should be okay. I wish we could Dragon Rage it. So we're just gonna Sand Attack him 6 times. How do you miss with the Peck? Good. That's 3 or 4, we're gonna say 3 to be safe. 4, 5. Can't go any lower. Okay, so that was 6. Uh, And how do we lower it slowly? With peck, I guess. Or not peck, tackle. Yeah, that'll work nicely. Okay. Don't crit. I don't think it's worth doing one more. Do we want to go for the sleep, though? I think we do. Thunderwave's not great. Use this to help us do our attack and to bait him into doing Thunderwaves again instead of Peck. And then we'll try to sleep him. Perfect. We got two of these, but here we go. Nope. And nope. Oh, wait, I need to put him back to sleep. Need to pay attention. Oh, there's the pack. How much does it do? Not much. That's not bad. He could crit that again, and it would not take us out. That's good. Okay. Now we keep spamming. Because as I don't have an electric type on our team yet, this would be wonderful to add to our party. Come on, come on, come on. Saving one life means saving the future. Welcome to the party, Shine Knight. We are just in the middle of probably wasting all our Pokeballs to catch a legendary. That was randomly bumped into. What am I doing? I want to sleep it. How are you doing tonight? Night? Oh, I'm certainly open to suggestions. Let's see if we actually catch it. he's asleep. Got him. I think this is worth going through all of our Pokeballs. Okay, that's not bad. We do need to heal in case he does a peck and crits. There's the peck. Let's sleep him again. Then heal again. More Pokeballs. What does a fastball actually do? I think it's just better if they have high speed, right? Pokeball that makes it easier to catch fast Pokemon. What else am I gonna use it? Might as well. Nope. I'm doing alright. This is probably like my 7th or 8th Nuzlocke attempt, and it's the best one so far. Just tonight, I caught our first two random legendaries. This is actually our 3rd one of the evening. It's going pretty well. He's still asleep. We might run out of sleep power points before we run out of Pokeballs. Oh, if you're interested, this is the party that I'm running with at the moment. This is one of the legendaries that we just caught a bit ago. It was actually our Sudowoodo encounter. It was I forget the actual race. Latias or Latios? Oh, it doesn't say here in battle. Pretty sure it's Laddie Ace. Yeah, I got through the third gym, did the Sudowoodo encounter, got the one legendary, lost two Pokemon to it, which is fine, because we replaced one of them with it. And then I went back and did the fishing encounters in the first three towns, and when we got back to the very, very beginning town and fished in the pond next to your starter house, I found and caught a Rayquaza, which is pretty lucky. I don't have the Rayquaza in the party because we're already pretty dragon heavy and weak to ice, and it's just going to take forever to level up, but it might be a good backup later on. Let's see. Continue wasting all these Pokeballs. Yeah, no kidding. He's awake. I'm definitely going to run out of power points before we run out of Pokeballs. Do I have any other really weak attacks that I might be able to hit him with once more? Only Agent, probably with a cut or something. No. I think we've lost all of our weak attacks. Let's keep going. Nope. Oh, that's next. It's been a long time, but I believe Premier Balls just have the same odds as a Pokeball. They're just prettier. So they'll be next after their Great Balls. But if you mention it, we'll try one. It's gonna be pretty cool if this is the one that catches it. Nope, not yet. Still asleep. Okay, let's finish these off though before we go to the weak ones. Nope. Okay, let's try to speedrun this here. I gotta pay attention to whether it's awake or not. There it is. Okay. Back to the Pokeballs. Man, it's so sad running into legendaries. They're just so hard to catch. 80% of the time, that's pretty good. What's your technique? Oh, I should have seen if any of my partner can use False Swipe. That'd be really nice. Although I'm honestly doing better than my previous runs already, but just by having Sleep Powder in the party. Oh, A, B, B, A, B, A, B, A, B, A, A, B. But does that work with a controller? A, B, B, A. Nope, not that one. Must be the other one. B, A, A, B. No, not this time. We'll keep trying. We'll try 18 more times. Oh, he's awake now. I need to put him back to sleep. Oh, this is the last sleepy time. Man. So sad to run into legendaries before you have a huge stockpile of Ultra Balls. That was our last sleepy time, so he's not going to be asleep for the last few here. But I am totally fine burning them all. 80% of the time, that's true. Now we're down to regular old Pokeballs. Gotta watch her hit points so I pay attention and don't get crit by a peck. A, B, enter A. Just try combinations of all the buttons while it's shaking. Something's gotta work. Okay, let's try to speed up here. Oh, there's the peck. Heal. I guess if I can't sleep him, there's no reason to keep our boy number one out here. James takes very little damage from the peck and is immune to his thundershock, so he'll be fine. 10, 9, 8, 7. It'll be fine. I'm spamming. Ah. Five. Four. Three. Two. Okay, last one. Come on. Ah. It wasn't meant to be. It'll be fine. Pretty good encounter, though. Jesse, not bad. I realized after naming our boy James here that it looks like I misspelled James, so Jesse would be pretty good. Okay. Well, I'm sad to say it when you just hopped on here, Shine Knight, but I've been on for 2 hours, I gotta get some dinner. I've just learned how to log into Twitch. I'll probably be on about this time most days, but maybe I'll see you around. Speaking of Pokemon, I can do the English dub of Krabby from the anime. Have a good night, mate. See ya.